Hello and welcome friends, my name is Aditya Pawar and let's start our journey to the universe. So in this video, we are going to talk about topological applications to black holes, in which we will discuss all the topologies applied to black holes as all the manifolds or complex manifolds and how the singularities are deformed into that topological invariant space. So let's get into it. So now let's get into it. So first I will explain what a topology is. So the viewers who don't know what topology is, I'll explain to them. So let's start. So topology is a subject where there are manifolds, certain type of manifolds as we have encountered, two-dimensional manifolds, three-dimensional manifolds, four-dimensional manifolds, and etc., going on to higher dimensional manifolds. So what topology basically is the twists and deformations of that map or space into another space or deformation such that this other space which you're mapping into it, making it a genus, or you could say that mapping the boundaries, the surface onto another surface. It can be anything, like if you're having a two-dimensional coordinate system x and y, you can map the same coordinate system onto a three-dimensional, which is x, y, and z. And also take an example that if you have x, y coordinate system and you have some figure, 2D figure drawn onto it, and you have to map that figure onto n spherical coordinates, you would just do the basic x, y, z, and you would have to determine the lengths from each angle to angle, which are basically noted by r, phi, and theta. So that was what topology is at a basic level, just mapping of spaces or twisting or bending and all the properties of doing with behaviors of spaces. That's topology. Now let's move on to the topologies of black holes. So on topology of black holes, we consider black holes as two-dimensional objects as we see them through our telescopes. But if we really observe them as a theoretical object, it would be like a 3D manifold or 4D manifold, as according to Einstein's general relativity, the space-time metric is a four-dimensional manifold, and hence the black hole should also be four-dimensional manifold plus the vector space in which this black hole is living, and especially to this type of black holes, as the black holes which are visible to us, the three main black holes, which are stellar black holes, intermediate black holes, and supermassive black holes, those are normal. Those are like just three-dimensional objects, plus one-dimensional, four-dimensional objects. And I've already explained to you about the particles, how do they interact with the black holes as they go beyond the event horizon. Now, this would be, in this lecture, we would just define the properties of black holes with the topological space embedded onto it and into it. So first we'll talk about the onto space around the topological black hole. So as we know, the region where black holes are located basically have the space-time metric curve, hence called Curvature metric space-time in general relativity. And now you can take all other kinds of space-times if you want to, like Vaidya space-time or ADS CFT space-time and many more. So now going into the black hole. So when going into the black hole, we have a lot of theoretical concepts and mathematical concepts. So I would not explain them all. I would just explain just a brief intro to those concepts. And if you want more detailed concepts into the interior and exterior, you can just comment below down that you want some extra deeper knowledge into the concepts. So just this video is just a basic intro to the topologies of black holes. So now into the surface, we can imagine a lot of hypotheses on into the surface. So now as you take the black hole, you can just take the topological space, whichever you can take, Hilbert or Hausdorff spaces. That would be either planar, as according to Gaussian curvature, so reference frame is Gaussian curvature. It would be plane, or it would be positive curvatured, it would be negative curvatured, also called as hyperbolic space. And so you can take any of these. When the Gaussian curvature is like zero, it is a flat metric space, when it's gray, when it's is equal to 1, it's positive curvature, and when it's equal to negative 1, it's hyperbolic. So that was into the interior of how the topological space is embedded. And if he particularly asks me that if in the case of a spherical black hole, not the two-dimensional black hole, if in the case of spherical black hole or such a black hole which has a topological cosmic string connected to another black hole, as we would consider it as wormhole or anything else. So in I will explain you about the scenarios. So the first scenario of a spherical black hole, as you understand the boundary conditions of the spherical black hole, you can draw all the world lines on light cones along any point to any point, say it's A to B, and that would be an algebraic outside the exterior or black hole on the surface. But if you calculate the same thing from inside the surface of black hole, it would be inverse function of the positive curvature outside, and with related terms into the length of that event horizon which it has. So as in terms the stellar black holes, in stellar black holes the distance between event horizon and the singularity is not very much, it is just about equal. But when talking about like supermassive black holes, we have a large distance to be covered, hence you take a lot of time to be covered. Hence the distance plus the exterior surface would give you the interior surface of that black hole. And as you would study in ADS-CFT of those black holes, which generally physicists call five-dimensional black holes or high-dimensional black holes, I'll give suggested links if you want to research further into the description box. So please check out the description box. And I've noticed that many viewers of my channel don't really like see the or read the description box, because the description box is like made customly by me and not like just given off. So it's just made by customly by me, and I want people to like research of your own self and then watch videos, and it would be a greater help, and as I do the same thing. Hence, so that was the introduction of the exterior and interior surfaces of a black hole. And yeah, the second thing, yeah, sorry, I forgot. So the second thing is that the black hole topologically cosmic string and another black hole. So in this scenario, it's very theoretical, but I would just try to explain or convert the theoretical thing onto a general basis, onto an informal basis. So you have a three-dimensional black hole, name it as S2 or S3, S cube. That you have a topological cosmic string. Take it as any cylindrical string. All the Gaussian curvatures which you have or we have studied, as far as positive curvature, flat, metric, and the hyperbolic curvature, anything you want, that connected onto another black hole. So basically, if you want to see the diagram, it's just hyperboloid diagram, but like more in a sense of black hole connecting to black hole. So not relying onto all the things necessary. It's just black holes, topological strings, and another black hole. So just concerning the same, just concerning the normal thing, not into wormhole physics, as not included here. We will include in future if you want when doing the advanced series. This is just basic intro series. So as this S3 is continuously formed or homeomorphic to S2 or S to the power 4, of dimensions, and there's a topological string. So the topological string would divide these sections, and the particular section would be given each particular vector, and then the vector would travel along this topological cosmic string, and then along the distance of the cylinder, and then try to reconnect onto the sphere for black hole. Basically, we see this type of phenomenon in the quantum level, as there are particles which are arbitrary according to the Schrödinger's equation, can exist at infinity states at one time superposition, as we call it, and can behave as another particle, so like without any exchange of force, like quantum entanglement. So basically what these particles do, as already imagine the light cone, and these particles going upwards in the future time-like direction when they are at present the point. These particles grow up into the future time-like direction, infinity, and they create another timeline or world line of themselves to just create another thing. This was like mentioned of referenced in Roger Penrose's lecture, as he was explaining in the CCC model that one particle can go into one time-like direction in the light cone and can also bounce or create a new direction. So the old direction will be the last point it would reach as the past time-like infinity point for the memory of the particle. But as the new life has started, it would just remember 3/4 of the new life and 1/4 of the afterlife. Well, 1/4 of the before life, to be exact. That was like how to just in quantum state and classical state. So like if you really try to figure this all out, that S cubed mapped on topologically onto an S4 dimension, it would be like very theoretical. And generally this idea, this type of idea isn't still introduced onto the general theory of relativity or the classical theory. It's only introduced onto the quantum mechanics mechanical theory. So we would just further study onto this topic or research by my own self to inform you guys that how would this phenomenon be the like explain you in further detail. So with that, that's my whole video as an introduction lecture to topologies on black holes, as still some of the viewers would get technical information, but we'll try to understand it as you comment below down your questions. I would feel free to answer them in any time. So that's with all the video, and please subscribe to my channel if you like my content, like the content if you like, share the content to spread more knowledge like this to other people, and comment below down if any doubts, queries or questions, and if any suggestions or inclinations you need, or any question suggestions you would need to specify into the video. And that's all for now. I'll see you in the next video. Till then, bye. Peace.